Hi guys, this is the Dental Assistant Tutor and I would like to go over endodontics. Your endodontic tray will have your basic setup, but it will also have an Endo Explorer on both ends that's pointy and long and thin, double end it, going different directions. That is an Endo Explorer. You also have an Endo Spoon. How it's different from the Endo, the regular spoon is that the working handle, the working part, okay, the working end is longer so it can get down into the canal and get out the decay. Then you have your spreader to spread your sealer before placing the gutta percha. So the doctor will have you mix up some tuba seal with a spatula and mixing pad, or they have some already in a capsule, and you would mix up the sealer. Apply the sealer, and then they will start filling the tooth in with the gutta percha. The gutta percha is a orange little point that goes inside the canal of the tooth to fill in where the pulp used to be and the nerve used to be down to the apex. That's where you need to get your working length in to get it just right. And when you take that working length x-ray, what they're looking for is that at the very tip of the apex and no further, that the sealer and the gutta percha is filling it up. And remember, it will show radio opaque on an x-ray. Radio opaque means something has been stopped, and that would be crowns, composites, fillings, 3x3s, and gutta percha. So when you look at an x-ray, you see that the canal of the tooth is filled with something white. They've had a root canal. Then with your plugger, it's the instrument that's burnt, okay? There are different instruments they might like to use, but it's the burnt one. Whichever one is burnt, this is a Woodson, okay? It looks kind of like a composite instrument, like a little Tiger Woods golf club. All right, that is a plugger also. So it just depends on what they would like to use. When they're doing that and you have either a lighter, make sure that you do not catch yourself on fire. Your gloves are not too tight but not too loose. You don't have no gauze around you. I would have a 2x2 wet gauze to take the plugger and wipe it off with, okay? Because he or she's gonna heat it up with the lighter or with a machine that is really nice and just melts it. But whenever you wipe off the instrument, wipe it off good. Let them feel that you're wiping it off with the 2x2 that is wet so you can get it off. You would have to write down the patient's chart, the anesthetic that you use, also what size gutta percha you use. Most of the time dentists will write that stuff up, but if you know how to do it, it would help out. The first appointment, normally in a root canal, would be opening up the tooth, cleaning it out, and when you do that, you're irrigating, okay? Before they fill it, they're going to irrigate the tooth. So what I like to do is have two cups out, one that has a B on it and one that has a P on it. Okay, most dentists, not every dentist, but it's up to them, okay, so there's no right or wrong, will use a syringe full of peroxide, or chlorhexidine, or they would use a syringe full of household bleach. Okay, they call it hydrochlorazine, okay? And that way the patient doesn't know that it's actually household bleach. And it's 50-50, half water, half bleach. Have it there and label and have your syringe labeled because they look identical. Okay, so how I do that is I take a permanent marker, which should be in a sterilization area, along with the autoclave tape that changes color. Rip a piece off and mark these. Take the lid off and retract into the cup, pulling up, making sure there's no air bubbles. Then put your syringe back together and have it on the table or the tray ready to go. Plus, having some in your cup, because sometimes they'll have to refill it. When you do have to refill it, sometimes they might bend the needle, so be careful recapping it and doing that. If you need to, A little trick is take a pair of hemostats and twist it off like this. Okay, that will help you. You want a pair of hemostats in case you need to use it with the Gutta Percha, or they have locking cotton pliers. And I like to have two with the endo tray plus my clean pair for this procedure, because when you're passing paper points, which just looks just like the Gutta Percha, just little points, but these are absorbent points. They're made out of paper to dry the inside of the canal. And it has to be very dry before they fill it, okay? And so you would have a 2x2 in your hand, this time a dry one, and you would pass the cotton pliers holding it secure, if they're not locking, with the paper point and passing it back and forth. And if he has another pair with the dirty paper point, you can take it like that and give him the another one. See how that will go? He'll take that, and then you give him this one, and you get another one ready. You just keep going to make the endo appointment go smoothly. You can write, like, the patient's, the date that they came in, the first appointment, root canal, left off at 25 file at 14 millimeters. If you place former Cresol inside the tooth, it's this chemical that smells, and it says former Cresol on the bottle. You take a little cotton pellet or a sponge and you dip it in there and you place it inside the tooth. And then you take the cavit, which is a soft putty jar. You'll see a jar about that big, about that tall, or unless they come in little tubes. And that's called cavit. That's temporary filling material. And you just pack it inside the tooth. If you're ever asked to place a temporary filling, don't panic, okay? Take the cotton pellet, stick it inside the tooth, okay? And then put the material inside, pushing down kind of like this. You can use your Whitson instrument. And you have it on there. You have it pointed. It's staying stuck onto the instrument. You put it down inside the canal and pack it, okay? Let them know they have a temporary filling and that it could come out and that they need to come back in to have it replaced. It's very important because they're going to get it bacteria back inside those canals, and that they have to come back to get the next part of the root canal completed. Some places endodontists can do an endo appointment from start to finish in one appointment. Some will break it up in two. Sometimes the tooth is questionable which tooth it is, and in that's the case, they would do a precaution test, okay? And they will take a mirror, and they will use the back of the mirror, and they'll say, is it one, is it two, or is it three? And they'll say, it's three. And then they'll say, well, I'm going to do it again. Is it one, is it two, is it three? And they'll say, it's one. Well, it's the same tooth. So just so you know, that's how they can check the nerve of the tooth if it's dying. Also, if it keeps them up at night, hot and colds bother it, sweets bother it. If there's a fistula, which is like a little pimple on the gum tissue when they first come in, that's how you know the tooth is infected. And all teeth, after they have a root canal, have to have a crown. Some have to have a buildup in crown if there's not that much tooth structure left. Another thing is about your suction tips is you would use the rubber dam, but you would also use the surgical suction tip that's green to help suction up the fluid that's coming out of the mouth. And basically that's it. When you are measuring files, make sure that you have the endo ruler, okay? And you just take the file, you have them in order from 8 to 70 if you need it. You pull it out, and if they say measure it to 25, you take that rubber stopper and you move it till it's there. And that is how you measure endo files. And the endo ruler could be on different things, and these could be put in different things, but this is basically how you do it. And they all get sterilized. And same with the gate glittens that go in the slow speed handpiece, and they go from 1 through 6, the gates glitten. That helps widen the canals. You could get a job just for endodontists and learn the specialty. If you have any questions, feel free to hit me up on my website. That's thedentalindexjr.weebly.com. Until next time, guys, have a good day. Bye.